Today we are going to be doing a tier list on all of Fortnite's collab skins. We're talking Marvel skins, we're talking Icon skins, we're talking Game and Legends, everything else in between. A brand and Fortnite made a skin. We're here to see where they go on my tier list. This is my opinion. You may have a different opinion. That is the beauty of a tier list. It's all opinions. There is no wrong opinion. There is no right opinion. I just thought this would make for a fun video. Also, I've probably missed a few skins. Fortnite's done a lot of collabs. I'm only doing like actual skins. I'm not doing back bling. So sorry, Rocket League, but you're not here. Let's have a look at the tiers for today's video. We're going to start it down low with big yikes. Like, this is a big yikes. We don't like this. Minor yikes, like, it's not the worst, but it's still not great. Average, like, this is, you know, this is not bad, not good. It's in the middle. It's like, it's an average collab. Then we got the that's dope. You know, you saw that in the item store and you said, that's dope. Gonna be the majority, I imagine. Then we've got S tier. This is the best of the best. You came on and you saw that and you thought, Fortnite, this is awesome. You are smart. And then last but not least, my favorite, with obviously bias in brackets, because I think we all know which one I'm gonna put there. Before we jump into the ranks, if you guys are going to enjoy this video, make sure to chuck us a like rating down below. If you guys didn't hear, Power Creative is doing a giveaway right now. 500,000 V-Bucks and 3 gaming consoles. Check out the link in the description. And of course, don't forget, check out Tiny Town and Fortnite Creative right now. It's one of our poppin' game modes, and we're going to be recording a lot of content on it throughout the weeks to come. Oh, and we're really close to 15 million. So if you could just hit that sub button, I'd really appreciate it. There's a lot of stuff to talk about. So I'm going to be ranking the skins on this kind of criteria of aesthetically, how I think the skin looks, you know, as a skin. Then on just like kind of brand presence, what that other brand is in the world, really, and what it means to me, that other brand, and having it in my favorite video game. Anyway, starting things off, Alloys, the latest gaming legends we have. I never played, I think it was Horizon Zero Dawn. I've never played the game. So, you know, it's not going to rank high for me. But I do like this skin aesthetically. I love the gaming legend series. I can't wait someday to see Samus or like Pokemon or some other like really big Nintendo game. But that's going to be a while. Alloy's probably going to rank on the low side for me. I didn't say that's dope when I saw it. So I'm going to put this in average. It would probably rank in between that's dope and average for me, but I didn't say that. If I didn't say that's dope when I saw it in the item shop, I would be discrediting the whole tier. So I'm going to put it in average. I think it's a great skin aesthetically, but I didn't play the game, so it doesn't have any value to me. Remember, to the person. Next up, Ant-Man. I think this might be one of the weaker Marvel skins. Love the Ant-Man movies. I love the Marvel movies. Obviously, we got a lot of Marvel in Fortnite, so I gotta be kind of, you know, a bit harsh on the ones that I don't like, because there's a lot that I do like. And Ant-Man's definitely low on the list. I don't see him in game often. Kind of like the movies. I don't really know if anyone really loved the Ant-Man movies. People like the Ant-Man movies, I think. I don't know. I think I'm gonna go with average on the Ant-Man one, just because, again, there's so many better Marvel choices. Next up, we got Aquaman. This was, of course, the Battle Pass skin for Chapter 2, Season 3. I loved how they kind of, you know, worked in the theme of, like, you know, the water season and everything. I was a bit disappointed how they did the Atlantis POI, because I thought we were going to get something really cool with Aquaman and, like, a Mythic Trident, and then we didn't. What is this place? Where's my Mythic Trident? Where are my different floppers?
Where is my content?
Well, I definitely did log on and go, that's dope. So I think he's definitely going to go on the dope one, because I did say, that's pretty dope. Next up, we got Astro Jack. This is actually a really cool skin. It's got two styles. I think this one's pretty dope. Not a lot of people run it in game, but when I see it, I'm like, yeah, that's pretty cool. Especially like the blue cyan looking style. I definitely probably have to put that, and that's dope. Not as good as the Travis Scott skin, obviously, but like still a strong one. Next up, we got Batman. I remember when this came out, because I was at the cottage and I wasn't there to play Fortnite for 2 days, and it came out and I was like, really? They're gonna add Batman to the game when I'm on holiday? Like, they're gonna do that. And they did that. I definitely think Batman, what it's about. Obviously, we've got the new 0.1 in the game as well now. I'm just gonna go ahead and chuck him into S tier. Like, it is Batman. All right, we don't have Superman yet, but when I think DC, I think everyone thinks Batman, Superman. It's like Marvel, it's like Iron Man, Thor, Captain America, and then it goes down from there. It's like Batman, and they did like a cool little collab with the back grappler. I'm gonna have to say S tier for that one. Next up, we got Black Manta. He's obviously the villain of Aquaman, and he came out the same season as Aquaman. Didn't see it in game. I did like the look of it. It was kind of cool, you know, bug eye looking dude. I'd probably have to put him under average, I reckon. Like, average to minor yikes. Like, I didn't really love it, but I thought it was pretty cool. It's a clean looking skin.
Look at this dude.
But it's nothing amazing. Next up, we got Black Panther. Rest in peace, Chadwick Boseman. The amazing actor who obviously played as Black Panther and who unfortunately passed away last year. An amazing skin, amazing movie. Definitely had some cool edit styles on top of that as well. I definitely have to rank that under that's dope. Borderline S tier, but definitely an awesome skin. Next up, we got the first Black Widow. So when this first came out, this was the first Marvel skin in Fortnite. Like, that was a big deal because this is why we didn't know anything was happening, and then it was her and Star-Lord. So at the time, I was like S tier, but then we got a lot more Marvel skins, and there's another Black Widow, and she's kind of better than this one. So I'm gonna leave it under that's dope, because I definitely did say that when it came out, and I probably would have put it on S tier, but I'll leave it at that's dope, because it kind of aged. I mean, how could you when you got Iron Man coming out? Next up, we got Loser Fruit. First Icon Series skin here. Now, obviously, you know, it gets weird when I talk about other creators, you know, skins and whatnot. You know, I debated on doing this video because everyone's going to get like a little bit up me for talking about their skins. But I feel like I've got a pretty good, honest opinion on where I sit with most of the Icon skins. Loser Fruit, amazing skin launch. Really awesome to see a female creator get a skin in the game. You know, everyone wants to talk about the guy from Fortnite. But Loser Fruit, the only girl from Fortnite. I mean, discounting the other fiction female characters. Like, Loser Fruit, you know, as a person, she's the only, like, icon that's a girl in the game. So shout out Loser Fruit. I reckon it's awesome. Some skin, I'm gonna have to put it in S tier. And also because, you know, going on that third point of my criteria, it's really awesome for me as a friend of these people to see them get skins in game. Like, that's so dope, seeing your friends get these awesome opportunities. So for a lot of reasons, it's S tier. I love how the skin looks. Obviously Cass is a good friend of mine as well, and she also kind of carries me when I play duos. Next up, we got Thick Boy Cable. Boy, he thick. Dummy thick. My boy big. He came out in a pack with three of them. I think he was the coolest one because he was the most jarring. I definitely said that's a pretty dope skin. I don't know who he is from Marvel. I don't know what movie, cinema. I didn't even heard of the guy, but he thick. And I said that's dope. Sorry, he's in the dope category for me. Next up, we got Captain Marvel, which I actually really like. If you guys didn't know, Brie Larson, the actor who plays Captain Marvel, actually got her own locker bundle. I always love things like that. But she actually got a skin in the game as well, as like under Captain Marvel. So came out with Black Panther and whatnot, obviously. I'd say it's another that's dope skin for me, Captain Marvel. I thought it was pretty clean. And you can change an edit style and it looks and glows all up. All right, that's a pretty strong one. Next up, we got Catwoman. I'm gonna be honest, it doesn't, you know, hit as hard for me. Borderline average to that's dope. I never was like, yo, Catwoman, crazy. I'd probably have to put that into average. I'm just not a massive Catwoman fan. Didn't really watch it in the movies. For me, I'm gonna put it in average. Next up, we got Chun-Li, which honestly, another, you know, character I didn't really know much about. Obviously, she's thick. And honestly, the whole Street Fighter collab was one of the cleanest collabs Fortnite's ever done. Like the promo, the everything. It was super sick. I'm definitely gonna put Chun-Li under that's dope, because I definitely was like, yeah, this is an awesome collab. Next up, we got the Lachlan skin. All right, now obviously made a separate tier to put this in, and you know, I'm not trying to say my skin is better than all the other skins. I'm just saying this skin means the most to me out of every other skin for a very obvious reason. For those of you who have been here on the journey, we've been playing Fortnite ever since it came out. Fortnite, you know, approached me with this opportunity for an Icon Series skin in the game. I think it was at the end of 2019, and my skin came out at the end of 2020. So it was about almost a year gap there. I think every night I went to bed thinking about it. Like, every night, because at the end of the day, it meant more to me than anything I was working on. And you know, when it came out, it's definitely very emotional because it was just such a big moment for me. And I'm very eternally thankful for Fortnite to have a skin in the game of the thing that I love playing still to this day. And it's the small things as well. Like, my back bling is definitely like a unifying thing in my community and power and all that stuff. And it's just really hard to sum up in words what it meant to me. The way I look at it is that I can die tomorrow, but I will live forever in Fortnite. That's how I look at it. And you know, some people may think that's cringe to think that, but that's just the reality of what that Icon skin is to me. And you know, there's other games I may play in the future, but I don't think I'll ever forget Fortnite. Similar to like how Pokemon is to me to this day. It's like, I'll never forget Pokemon. And that launch week for my skin, I'll never forget. Even all the build up, going through the concept art. I do have the concept art, by the way. So if you guys wanna see that in a separate video, let me know. But yeah, it's there for obvious reasons. I think we understand why. Anyway, Almost got a little emotional there, like we did when I first got my skin. And yeah, on a final note, I just want to thank everybody for all the support over the years, because without you guys, there's no way I'd have a skin in Fortnite. Anyway, nearly getting a little emotional there. Let's keep on moving. Next up, we got the clutch skin. So this is the first Nike skin. I definitely said that's dope on launch. I remember this is World Cup meta. Me and Fresh were playing a lot. That was like one of the funnest times in Fortnite, playing World Cup Fortnite with Fresh. I definitely have to put it into that's dope. What it really meant to the Fortnite culture was that Fortnite and Epic were like so cool with just adding in brands. Like seeing the Nike tick on the shoes was like, whoa, like it feels so metaverse crazy. Like definitely sent a message to me and most of the community, like this is what they wanted to keep on doing. And I thought that was a really kind of groundbreaking one in a way. So definitely that's dope for sure on the clutch. Next up, we got Daredevil. I'm not gonna lie, this one was probably the worst Marvel skin we'd had. You had to play a competition to get it for free. But I remember everybody else just putting on the superhero suit and just putting red on it and just saying, hey, I have the Daredevil skin. I just think it didn't really work as well because it was just so similar to the superhero skins. I know there's people who like the skins that I might not rank highly, and I'm sorry if I offend you, but I think I'm gonna have to put Daredevil in a minor yikes one, just because again, some of the Marvel ones are so much better. Alrighty, next up we have Daryl from Walking Dead. A little context, I myself have never watched The Walking Dead. It doesn't have that value to me, so I can't really rank it highly. I did like the knife, the pickaxe knife. I thought that was really cool. For me, it didn't really do anything, but the knife will definitely put it up to average for me. But Walking Dead, that's not a crazy one for me. Next up, we got Deadpool Chapter 2 Season 2, one of the best recent seasons that we've had. I think they did an amazing job with Deadpool rolling it out in the battle pass, all the, you know, definitely taking its humor of just, you know, doing weird stuff and, you know, taking over the yacht and stuff like that. Super cool. Gonna chuck it into S tier because I think that's where it belongs. However, I will say once again, Epic, I don't know what you were thinking with the Deadpool pistols. You made them way too weak, and I'm still mad about it 4 seasons later. Sorry, but like that really annoyed me because they should have been better. All right, next up, we got Demogorgon. Personally, never watched much Stranger Things, but aesthetically, I thought this skin was dope. I definitely said that's dope. Demogorgon skin is like the first one to really have a weird head that opened up like a flower. This is the one that's gonna get there just because it aesthetically looks cool. I don't really watch Stranger Things, but definitely gonna put that up there on the dope one for me because that's a cool skin. Next up, we have Diamond Hands. Now, this skin is amazing, and I don't know who at Epic decided like to do this, but this is one of the best ideas ever. It's taking 2 memes, and the thing with memes is that no one really owns them, so it's like public domain. And you know, they could have got lazy and just done the Stonks guy, but no, they combined it with the Diamond Hands meme, made it something new, and put it on the store for April Fool's. 10 out of 10 through and through, amazing idea, especially in the climate of, you know, Stonks culture and everything like that. Just great marketing, great idea, execution of the skin. It's 10, 10, 10. It's S tier. Like, it just is. It's definitely one of the more recent times I've been like, hats off, that's a 10. And it definitely reflected in the sales because that thing is just sick. I gotta speed through some of these Marvel skins here. Domino, I just don't have any real attachment or care about the skin. I think it was the weakest of the 3 that it came out with. I don't know it all from Marvel, so I'm gonna go with minor yikes there. I just got Travis Scott on the list here, so I'm gonna say minor yikes. It's not to say it's bad, it's just in comparison to everything else, it's just not as good. Dr. Doom, I don't really know Dr. Doom before season 4, and I think that is kind of one of the good things when you look at it, because I think they're setting up a Dr. Doom movie. And what better way to plant the seed than to put it in a Fortnite collab? That's very smart. And you know what? I didn't mind Dr. Doom by the end of it. I'd probably put him an average, you know? But his cosmetics were kind of cool. The chair was kind of dope, even though it was Victor Royale. But I'd almost put it up to that's dope. Next up, we got my boy Laserbeam. You already know. My boy Lannan, me and him, we've been making Fortnite videos for the longest time. We don't make as many videos as much in recent years, but we definitely still hit the odd stream and whatnot. Lannan, great guy. Similar to Loserfruit. Just so happy to see one of my friends get a skin in Fortnite. And you know, Lannan definitely took a different route with this skin, trying to pick a tradie skin, because obviously that's what he did when he first got out of high school. So I definitely have to chuck this one in S tier, no doubt. Gingy back bling. My guy literally got code laser tatted to him so he could get it in Fortnite. 500 IQ, then like, respect. So next up, we got an Aliens collab. Now, this is a very old movie that she features in. Google here says she came out in 1979. And her last appearance was in 2014. When I think of her, I think of the very old movies. You know, I think it's really cool. You know, I don't have an attachment really to this, you know, kind of skin or character. And I don't think a lot of the players do either. I do like the skin. I do like Aliens, but the Aliens movie I watched were the ones that she wasn't in. I'll probably put it into average because I definitely think it's better than Daredevil in that, but not a high one for me. So we put in the soccer skins here because they're technically a collab with FIFA. Soccer skins, when they first came out, as just the generic ones, were like a big culture within Fortnite, you know, oh my God, sweaty soccer skins. Only the OG kids will remember that struggle. Then they came out with the next ones in collaboration with the FIFA so you could get the different teams and whatnot. I think it was like a couple Australian teams as well. So it's not just FIFA. Yeah, I think I definitely said that's dope when it came out because I was like, that's cool. Especially when they had like clubs from not just FIFA. That's dope. Next up, we have some Star Wars skins. We're looking at Finn here. I remember watching the movie that he's from. I don't have the craziest attachment to Star Wars. So I don't know where I'd probably put him. I want to say average. I don't really know or care too much about it. I think it was cool, but I didn't think it was dope. Next up, we have The Flash. Now, if you guys don't know, I actually played in the Pro-Am with Robbie Amell, who was one of the actors for Flash. But yeah, Flash, a little bit of beef with this guy. Our backlings look very similar. Our pickaxes look very similar. And you know, we both got lightning bolt branding, so it was probably going to happen at one point. But to me, personally, when I saw the skin, you know, I didn't say that's dope. I didn't say that's dope. I was like, oof. I'll probably put him in minor reaction because of the pickaxes. I'll probably put it in average, actually. I'm just being bitter. Next up, we got Ghost Rider. This is a strong Marvel one. I definitely said that's dope when it came out. The glider was dope. Pickaxes with the whips were dope. Skin was sick. Apparently, he's meant to be one of the strongest characters in Marvel. I read it on the internet. It must be true. So Ghost Rider was sick. Definitely a dope one. All right, next up, we got Ghostbusters. I liked this. I timed it with Halloween. Halloween collab. Ghostbusters. A little bit, you know, old school for probably the modern day kids, but I thought it was really cool getting them in there. I really hate when they try to break skins up into 8 different skins. I don't like that. Looking at you, Tron. And for that reason, I'm not going to rank it as highly because I don't like that. But I did think some of the actual Ghostbusters were cool. One of them kind of looked like me as well. So I'd probably go with average for Ghostbusters. Next up, we got Green Arrow. He was a crew pack skin. I don't really know Green Arrow that much, so I can't really rank it that highly. We had some really cool Marvel skins just come out the season before. Hawkeye, probably my favorite Archer, you know, superhero. So out of respect to my guy, Hawkeye, I'll probably put it in minor yikes. Like, I just didn't think it was that crazy. Next up, we got my boy, Graf G. My boy, Graf, had the most solid launch for his skin coming out in Fortnite. Obviously broke the Twitch record as well. Super cool dude. It was fun playing games with him both when my skin came out and when his skin came out. And then, of course, we did the games with Lufu and Ninja as well. Cool dude. Awesome skin concept. Went for like a Dragon Ball Z kind of design. Definitely one of my favorites. And again, definitely cool to see some other regions get some love. So definitely S tier, my boy Graf G. Next up, we got Grind. I got to speed through a couple of these here. Probably going to chuck it under like that's dope again, because it was pretty much the same as Clutch for me. It's the Nike skin. They're the same. You know, it was like, that's dope. Next up, we got Groot. I thought, yeah, this is definitely one of the stronger Marvel skins we had in the game. I think Lannan did like a tree meme with it. Definitely some meme potential there. Also came with Rocket, but you know, that was kind of a bit pay to lose. I think for Groot, I'd probably chuck him under that's dope. I definitely saw that, was like, yeah, dope skin. Next up, we got Harley Quinn. At the moment, she currently has the rebirth version in game. Slightly controversial. I think I have to chuck it into S tier. And maybe that's not controversial because when this skin came out, everyone was using it. I thought it was dope. I really liked the skin design. You know, everyone loves Harley Quinn. One of the best collab skins we've seen. Therefore, I think it's going to go S tier. Next up, we got Hopper. Stranger Things, once again, not as cool as Demogorgon. I didn't watch Stranger Things, so it's hard. It's average or minor yikes. And it's, I probably should have changed yikes. It sounds a bit offensive, but it's like, yeah, I personally don't care for it as much as I could other skins. Iron Man, I'm not even going to discuss this. It's S tier because it just is. It's Iron Man. There will be no explanation. Next up, we got the J Balvin edit style for the Party Trooper. I feel a little weird because this skin was really dope, especially the edit style for J Balvin. I thought the promo for it was a little interesting and a bit confusing because even I didn't even know how to really kind of get it. It was like some Party Royale login type thing. Definitely a dope skin collab in Fortnite and probably start popping off again in Halloween. You know, skin lockers definitely are seasonal because people want to live in the season. Next up, we got John Wick. Definitely saw the trailer, was like, that's dope. The game mode was dope. They added the Continental to Tilted Towers. That was dope. Almost S tier. And I think it would if it, you know, didn't come out kind of as like that scuffed John Wick back in chapter 1, season 3 or season 4. I forget when it came out. But still super awesome skin. Definitely got to chuck it under that's dope because it is dope. Next up, we got the Joker. I saw this, was like, this is dope. In a couple styles. Yeah, definitely a that's dope skin. Not quite S tier. Definitely dope. Now, Kratos is a bit of an interesting one. Never played any of the games that he's from. Don't even know what it's called. Legend of War? God of War? I don't even know. Never really had a PlayStation. So, didn't really mean a lot. The pickaxe was one of the best pickaxes in the game. Still one of the best pickaxes in the game. But still really dope because it was one of the first gaming legend skins in the game. And I definitely was like, that's dope. Now, we got a Battlebreaker skin. Kuruhumura. I definitely butchered that. I apologize. I think the skin aesthetically carries it. Like, I think it's actually a cool looking skin. I've never played Battlebreakers. It might be a great game. I don't know. I haven't played it. I will put it into under average because I think the skin aesthetically looks cool. Next up, we got Kylo Ren. This one was definitely one of the stronger Star Wars skins. Definitely saw that. I was like, yeah, that's dope. Black Widow 2, definitely cooler than the last Black Widow. But at this point, Marvel skins weren't as, you know, cool when they came out. So I'd have to put it under average. Next up, we have Major Lazer. Now, I'm not going to lie. I can't rank this one too high. It's one of the first Icon Series skins we ever got before they actually made it an Icon Series skin. I think the design's pretty cool. The dance is one of the best dances in the game. It's iconic to me in Fresh's kind of like series during Showdown Under. Like that was like kind of iconic. And that's the only thing holding it in here. I'd have to say Major Lazer would be average. I don't think it's that impactful. There wasn't really any concert that gave it kind of any meaning. So I'd probably put Major Lazer as an average collab, you know, in the middle. And then we got the Mandalorian, which by the way, 500 IQ marketing, because I didn't watch Mandalorian. I watched a little bit of Star Wars. I don't watch a lot of it. Mandalorian came out in Fortnite. And then guess what I did? I watched Mandalorian. And guess what? Unbelievable. Such a good series. I loved it. I sat through Twitter and saw all the Baby Yoda memes. Didn't know what Baby Yoda was. Just saw that he was cute. And then I watched the series. I was like, fair enough. Like, this is what the hype's about. And this one's going high up on the S tier. Another round of applause to Epic. That was a good one. I really enjoyed that one. It's 500 IQ from Disney doing these kind of collabs. That makes so much sense. Great series. Great skin for today. Next up, we got Blade, who had the really cool shing, shing, shing. That was like the first pickaxe that came out. And I was like, yo, that is a sick pickaxe. That's definitely dope. The skin itself isn't that cool, but it was like the first back bling, like pickaxe skin. And like the shing, shing, nah, it was good. It was dope. Pickaxe honestly brought it up there. Next up, we got Marshmallow. I really love the Marshmallow brand. I love the Marshmallow music. Marshmallow also got that, you know, kind of context in the Fortnite culture. Won the first Pro-Am with Ninja. It was iconic. Skin was great. Performance at Pleasant Park was great. I think this one's undisputedly an S tier skin. There's a reason everybody wants it back in the store because they want Marshmallow. Fair enough. It's S tier, 100%. Speaking of S tier, Master Chief. As a teenager, I loved Halo. I loved the storyline of Halo. I cannot wait to play the next one. I'd almost chuck it up there with my own skin. If I could do my number one favorite collab skin after myself, it'd be Master Chief because that's just so cool. I love Master Chief. One of the sickest collabs ever. Who doesn't love Master Chief? I still need to get the black edit style. I don't have an Xbox One. S or whatever it is he says. Same with the Walking Dead here again. I'll chuck them in respectively an average, but it just didn't mean anything really to me as a collab. Next up, we got Captain America. He is worthy. And, you know, this kind of set up the whole season 4 story, I think, because this came out in season 3. Definitely saw that. Was like, that's dope. Definitely wouldn't say S tier. Dope skin. You know, love Captain America, but he ain't no Iron Man. You know what I'm saying? Next up, we got Mystique. I actually really liked this skin because it had that extra utility of, you know, transforming into the skin you just eliminated. Really awesome idea. Really awesome concept. That just added a whole nother ball game because you could get content out of that. I think effectively, I have to chuck it in S tier for that alone because content is king and Mystique provided what none of these skins could ever do. Like, I don't know how many content videos Mystique is involved in. Again, it's all, you know, eye of the beholder opinion. Content, S tier. All right, so next up, we got Neymar, the latest Fortnite Battle Pass skin. I thought it was really awesome to get, like, you know, an athlete, a really high-level athlete in the game. I thought the trailer that came out with it was super sick. One of the best trailers that's ever happened in Fortnite, and they got some bangers. Unfortunately, I don't really care about football or soccer as much as most of Europe, and I understand Europe's a massive region. I have a lot of viewers from Europe. You definitely would rank the skin higher than me because I don't really follow football that much. I definitely saw it and was like, that's dope. But for me personally, it's not an S tier collab. If I was from Brazil or Europe, 100% undoubtedly be S tier. But unfortunately, I'm from Australia. Next up, we got the NFL skins. I remember waking up, checking my iPhone, seeing the announcement. I'm pretty sure the words I said out of my mouth were, that's dope. So accurately, he will go there. Like Neymar, it's really awesome to see traditional sports and sporting brands get involved with Fortnite. Love to see it. Always love to support it. One of the biggest collabs Fortnite's done back in that era. That's dope. Big Boy Ninja. Now, undoubtedly, before we even go through all the opinions, big yikes. Nah, I'm kidding. This guy is absolutely S tier. What he did with Fortnite is undisputed as one of the GOAT acts. Great guy. Love playing games with Tyler. Skin aesthetically is awesome. I remember when it came out and I was just looking forward to it because I think I'd just been kind of told that I was getting one and I was just super hyped to see Ninja get his skin in game. Definitely well-deserved. You know, it's unfortunate he doesn't play Fortnite as much as he does these days, but still an S tier skin. No one can dispute that. Next up, we got Poison Ivy. This one's dope. I saw it and I was like, I don't even know who Poison Ivy is. Skin design looks cool. Little edit style. That's dope. In my book, I said that was a good skin. This is going to be a long video. All right, next up, we got the Predator. I really like this skin. I really like the Predator series. I remember watching the movies as a kid, being very, very scared. And now it's a Fortnite skin. So that's pretty cool. I'd almost go S tier on this, but I'd have to go with that's dope. I love seeing the Predator in Fortnite. I didn't like the Mythic. I think could have been some changes there, but definitely a dope collab. Psycho Bandit. Now, this is a hard one because he's borderline S tier for me. He was the first gaming legends before it was gaming legends in Fortnite. The whole Borderlands collab was so cool. You got max shields. I really loved Borderlands as a game and as a brand. So for me personally, I'd probably have to put it into S tier. Like the Master Chiefs, like the Batmans, like the Deadpools. These are the brands you want to see in the game. And nah, Psycho Bandit definitely high up there for me. Psylocke, one of the strongest of the three from that whole collab. Probably have to put her under average. Didn't like her as much as Cable. Better than Domino, but yeah, she was cool, but she wasn't like, I wouldn't call her dope. Next up, we got Raven from the Battle Pass this season. I watched Teen Titans as a kid. Looks a lot different than the Raven I remember from Teen Titans. I'll probably go average with Raven. And again, you know, aesthetic. I think the skin's cool. It's just I'm thinking more about, like, you know, what the brand means to me and stuff like that. But Raven, not a crazy one on my list. The biggest problem is that these skins aren't bad on their own. You remove the top and these are insane collaborations, but you're just getting outweighed by Master Chief. It's a bell curve, you know. In order for there to be good ones, there must be bad ones. Next up, we got Razor. His Battle Breakers. I have to put it under minor yikes. I thought the other one was way cooler, and I didn't even think that was that cool. Like, Battle Breakers is a very new brand. I don't think many people are aware with it. It's obviously smart and epic to, you know, try and do the collabs with their own games and such. Just for me, it doesn't hold a lot of value, especially in comparison to the rest of the list. Next up, we have Ray. Really awesome looking skin. I'd probably have to go right next to my boy Finn here, but probably closer to that's dope because it was a good female skin. I probably could go that's dope. I never really wore it. I'll probably put it on average for me. I thought the other Star Wars skins were a little bit better. Yeah, Rue, here we go. Definitely the cleanest collab. The only skin, I think, in the game that is also in Smash Bros. That is also in this game as well. That's dope. Saw that. They were Chun-Li. I'm like, yeah, that's dope. That's a good skin. Sarah Connor. It's kind of like that alien one, you know? It's a little bit old. I mean, technically not old because she's in the current movies, but I just think about the old school Terminator movies when I think of Sarah Connor. I think it was a pretty cool collab. I think most of the hype there was for the Terminator itself. So I'll probably put it on average for me personally. Oh, actually, nah, I'll probably put that's dope because the cap and the shades look kind of cool. Yeah, it is a clean looking skin aesthetically. She-Hulk. I actually really like She-Hulk. Both forms. I thought that was a dope looking skin. I'm gonna put it in dope because I actually really I like She-Hulk. Like Jennifer Walters, Rainbow Jennifer Walters, pretty good. Next up we got Silver Surfer. I thought he was pretty good. His glider is one of my favorites to this day. I saw it in the store and I did say that's dope. No, I did. Because it was like, it was a bit interesting. I'll put it under that. I don't really care too much about Silver Surfer and how he is in the movies. But I thought it was a dope Marvel collab. I think that's a fair place to put it for me. And I do really enjoy the glider. It's in most of my videos. Next up, we got Sith Trooper. I saw this one. I said that's dope. I saw that along with Stormtrooper. I'm going to put them both there because they both mean the same to me. I saw them both and I was like, all right, yeah, that's dope. Especially the Stormtrooper, more so than the Sith Trooper. Now, these are cool skins. And, you know, this is like Star Wars when you think of Star Wars. And the only way you can level up from there is Mandalorian. Next up, we have Snake Eyes. Really like this skin. I never played with G.I. Joes as a kid. I think it might be a bit American, but I really like the sword. I said that's dope when I saw it. So, I mean, that's what the tier is there for. I saw it. I said that's dope. So it goes in the tier. Snake Eyes was a good skin, in my opinion. It was very clean. Works well with my back bling. I like it. Sophia. So if you guys don't know, this is the female from the last John Wick movie or one of the John Wick movies. I thought it was an interesting looking skin. I didn't think it was that very popular. I'd probably have to go average if John Wick's dope, because it wasn't as good as John Wick, in my opinion. And I definitely didn't think, you know, that's dope. All right, we're on the last leg here. We got Star-Lord. So similar to Black Widow, the first Black Widow that came out. This was just like a big deal to me. Like, you know, it's one of the first Marvel skins in the game. I have to rank it the same as Black Widow just because it was such a big deal back then. Like, it's just, it's crazy, man. So even though it hasn't aged as well, it's still, you know, initially that's dope. Storm, I didn't think was too crazy in my books. Mythic was awful as well. Didn't hit too crazy with the Storm. I think I'll chuck her into average, unfortunately. I think her pickaxe is pretty good though. Terminator, I was really hyped for this collab. The skin didn't feel as good in the end, and I definitely remember using Sarah Connor more than Terminator, but yeah, really awesome collab to see Terminator in Fortnite. I don't think really saw that one coming. Really awesome collab, in my opinion. Taskmaster. Now, I have to be honest, I don't know who this guy is. And that's key, because I don't know who he is. Like, I got Black Panther, Captain Marvel, and Taskmaster. Like, this guy is a master of doing tasks. I'm gonna put him in minor yikes, because I just didn't know who he was. Next up, we got Big Bad Boy Thor. It doesn't look like Chris Hemsworth, and I don't know how I feel about that. Because, like, Black Widow kind of looks like Scarlett Johansson, but, like, for some reason, Thor doesn't look like Chris Hemsworth. And he'd probably go S tier if he did, but he doesn't. I know it's probably because they're trying to stay true to the comic books, and I imagine that's why. It's definitely dope, not S tier, because it's not Chris Hemsworth, in my opinion. But everyone loves Thor. I can't wait to see the next Thor movie, because Chris Hemsworth in it. Next up, this guy doesn't need any introduction here. He's going straight to the top. There's a reason everybody is waiting for this skin to come out. It was his birthday 3-4 days ago. Happy birthday, Travis Scott. Everyone thought his skin was coming out because the item shot was resetting at a weird time, and then we got red versus blue skins. Everyone was like, wait, hold up. But yeah, Travis Scott concert was absolutely insane. Big fan of Travis Scott's music. It's S tier, there's no debate. It's not even close. Travis Scott's one of the best skins in the game. And then we got Tron, and Tron wins my award of the only skin on this list with the big yikes. I really didn't think the skin was even that good. And two, how many versions of Tron were there? I think there was 8. Nah. You're done. The skin wasn't that great to begin with, and then you're doing 8 of them. I could be wrong here. How many Tron skins were there? Bro, there was 10 of them. Yeah, okay, I thought, okay, yeah, no. And that's why you're getting big yikes. This skin, like, aesthetically, there was some cooler ones than others, but you can't be doing 10. I know Ghostbusters might have done 8 or 10 too, but that actually looked kind of cool and was themed Halloween. Tron, sorry, mate. I actually really liked the movie, but the Fortnite collab for me, I didn't like it that much. Venom, on the other hand, where he borderline S-tiering this gang right now. Obviously, he can't go S-tier because competitively you can't use Thick Boy, but Venom was such a dope skin. That was such an awesome one. Everyone wanted to win the Venom Cup because they wanted Venom early. Nah, it was a good skin. Aesthetically, awesome skin. Really loved the Venom. Next up, we have Wolverine, which is one of the skins I'd border close to S-tier, but I like Wolverine. I don't love Wolverine. I probably have to put it next to Venom. Really awesome skin. Really solid. Definitely dope. I don't know if I could go with S tier. Next, we've got Zori Bliss, which I don't really know what that is. I can't really rank it that highly. I'd probably have to put average, maybe minor yikes. Nah, Finn and Rey are way better. I don't know what that is. That's kind of key when you're ranking the skin. If you don't know what it is. And last but not least, Xenomorphs. Definitely got to go on there. That's dope. Man, that movie scared the... I thought I got scared in the Predator movie. Dude, when I first saw one of the face huggers come out of someone's chest in an Aliens movie, bro, that was nightmare for a week. That was nightmare for a week. And now it's a Fortnite skin. So I hope you all got nightmares, but just remember, it's not real. So there's nothing to worry about. But yeah, this is my list of all the skins in Fortnite. Obviously, just don't even include this as like part of the screenshot because that's just me being biased as hell. But yeah, everything else, let me know what you thought. You know, I definitely may have put one of your favorite skins down the bottom. I apologize. Some of these other skins just are some of my favorites. And you know, all in all, apart from maybe Tron, I think these are all great skins. And you know, at the end of the day, these collaborations in Fortnite are super awesome to see. I can't wait to see more Icon skins. I can't wait to see more Gaming Legends skins. Those are the two of my favorite categories of skins because I think everyone can just, you know, get behind what those are about. So yeah, I look forward to more of those. If you guys enjoyed my tier list video, make sure to chuck us a like rating down below. Subscribe to the channel if you're new, and I'll catch you guys next time. Later, guys.